Hi there, guys, welcome back. Today we'll be jumping straight into this. You know what we're watching, let's get into it. Last time we left off with the group being unprepared for the androids, and we left off at the very end with the likes of Chi Chi, Goku, and Future Goten coming out of the time chamber and sensing a bit of a standoff. Let's jump back a little bit and get to the point where Future Gohan and Present Gohan leave the time chamber. With them coming out of the time chamber, they sense around trying to find Piccolo, who is currently around Roshi's house looking for the androids. He is joined by the likes of the hybrids, and the search for the androids does continue to go down. After a few hours, the androids do show themselves at Master Roshi's house. With the likes of the Earthlings being there, they quickly let their energy jump up to allow the likes of the Gohans and Piccolo to understand something is happening there, which leads them to start rocking off towards Kame House. Now, this isn't just a signal for them, but it's also a signal for Cell. Cell, sensing this, assumes that the androids must be nearby, and he heads towards there as well. Much slower and much quieter, but he tries his best to get there at some speed. Now, at the house, a fight hasn't broken out, but it does sort of become a race, with Piccolo trying to sense out for Cell. After all, he's pretty smart and would figure out that Cell would sense the energy of the Earthlings would be heading there. However, he's having no luck. Luckily for the group, the three Z fighters manage to make it to the house first. The androids look over to the three fighters, and them noticing how they have no data on one of the three. In fact, even the ones they have data on are a lot stronger than they should be, with Gohan reading to be older than he should be as well. With 16 pointing this out, the three warriors sort of just look at one another. They stare down the androids, amazed. After all, this is the first time they have met the androids, well, at least this timeline's versions. They run into them, with Future Gohan getting angry just looking at them. However, he is confused by the likes of 16, but does look past this. The androids begin to ask for Goku, with Piccolo responding that they won't get a chance to meet Goku, or even see him, they're going to stop him here. With the androids entertained by this threat, they gesture over to an island, with 17 saying, "Wanna test that theory?" Piccolo, getting ready to take off his weighty clothing, is cut off by Future Gohan, saying how he will take all of them on if they want to die that badly. 17 sort of chuckles to himself alongside Android 18, before saying, "Are you sure about that, buddy? I don't want to hurt your feelings or anything, but you're a hand down. You know, maybe have a hand from your friends." With this pissing Gohan off, with the hybrid saying that he will be able to defeat all three of them with this one hand. 18 saying how this one isn't very confident, we should probably teach him a lesson. But 16 does say that he won't be fighting anyone who is not Goku. 17 and 18, not bothered by this, do get ready to fight over at the nearby island. 17 and 18 getting ready to fight. Do give Gohan one last warning, saying how at least make this somewhat entertaining for us. Take a hand, even if it's green. With 17 snickering to himself. However, after this joke is made, Future Gohan lets off his full power, with him having a smirk on his face. The power gets picked up by 16 sensors, and he warns his siblings that that warrior right there is Gohan. He doesn't know how or why, but he is much stronger and older than he could have possibly be. With 17 and 18 confused by this, 17 is soon hit by a kick to the face, sending the androids flying backwards and almost took his head straight off. With the androids wiping the blood from his mouth, 18 and 17 begin to move in sync, with Gohan standing there in confidence. Gohan just stands there, dodging all attacks thrown at him. There's a multitude of reasons why he's managing to dodge them. Things such as the fact he knows how the androids move, and he actually massively outclasses them in terms of speed and power individually. However, Gohan does also know that if they are working together, he can lose to these two, and with some effort, they could actually beat him. With the fight going on for a few minutes, the other two fighters present, with that being Present Gohan and Piccolo, are wanting to jump in to help out him. However, just before they do anything, after a punch from Future Gohan knocking one of the androids into the water, this being Android 18, he turns his attention over to 17, getting ready to finish this off, but is soon cut off by the power of something weird rising massively. Piccolo and the Earthlings actually recognizing this energy as Cell, maybe? It's gotten stronger, and the moment Piccolo puts it together fully, he begins to panic. After a few seconds, semi-perfect Cell rises out of the water, with him clapping, thanking Gohan for the hand. In return, he will be helping him out, with Cell again beginning to rush towards 17. However, he is cut off by Piccolo, who, in the moment, panicked, got close up to Cell and fired a ki beam straight at his chest. This doesn't harm Cell, but thanks to it being out of the blue and unexpected, it pushes the Bugman away. This being done, Piccolo turns towards the injured future Gohan and Android 17, shouting out that they need to get out of here. And future Gohan and 17 are confused at who that is. But Piccolo shouts out again that they need to get out of here. The android needs to either get the fuck out of here or let Gohan kill him. This thing is too incredibly strong, and if it absorbs 17, he becomes stronger. Everyone is really confused. With 17 confused at where his sister is, Cell explains how she just became part of him and soon he will be joining her. With 17 getting angry at this, he gets ready to fight the Bugman to get back his sister. However, Piccolo shouts out once more that if he gets absorbed, this thing might become unstoppable. 17 is almost about to argue, however, 16 soon says that leaving is the best option. You and the older Gohan should leave. Your injuries are severe, and if you stay, you will just get in our way, and if he absorbs you, he will get stronger. With him saying how he will stay and fight off this bug, with the help from the smaller Gohan and Piccolo, take this chance to run, we will buy you some time. Future Gohan does want to argue about it, however, he does bite his tongue, telling 17 to leave with him, quickly. 17 is shocked at how Gohan is just acting after they fight, but the two begin to leave, with Future Gohan right now understanding that if he was to start a fight with 17, it would more likely end in a draw, thanks to the fact that the android has infinite energy, so he can hold off against Gohan for ages, while he's quite heavily fatigued and injured. The two, for now, make a somewhat of an alliance, heading off to any nearby island where they can at least just hide for a few minutes. Now, with this happening, the Earthlings who are nearby also know they should head off. They won't be able to help much here. This just leaves 16 Piccolo and present Gohan, but the three fighters are unsure of how this fight will go. But for an idea, present Gohan is weaker than semi-perfect Cell, but is stronger than Kanon Vegeta, but semi-perfect Cell is also stronger thanks to the fact that Goku unlocked the Akari form ages ago, which led to him getting a bigger, you know, it design increase. Right now, the only person who can truly hold off Cell is Gohan. With the help of both 16 and Piccolo, the chances of Gohan winning are in his favour, but they don't really have much time to discuss a strategy. Cell's getting annoyed at the sight of 17 flying away. With him going off to rush after him, present Gohan disappears and then reappears in front of Cell. He kicks Cell straight towards the ground, before taking a fighting stance, similar to his mother's. Cell laughs at this, and is impressed by the growth of Gohan, however he too also takes a fighting stance. With Gohan rushing towards Cell, he is going straight for the face, hoping to take off the bug's head, but just before impact, Cell catches the blow, with him then going to take some of Gohan's energy using his tail. But thinking fast, Gohan summons up a Kienzan with his free hand and throws it up towards the arm which is holding him. With this cutting him free, he then kicks off Cell's torso, sending him back away from Cell, letting him avoid the attack from the tail. Cell grabs the place which the Kienzan cut before forcing out a new arm, with Gohan understanding that he has some form of regeneration, and he's going to have to do some serious damage to finish off Cell. With this giving Gohan an idea, he turns towards the likes of Piccolo and 16, telling them that if they want to help out, they need to make sure that they can make two massive attacks. Cell's out of your league right now, but with a big enough attack, we might be able to take him down. With Piccolo agreeing to this, he starts thinking of an attack that could do this. 16 says how if they both go for a massive attack, the island itself will be destroyed, and it could lead to him getting killed and maybe Cell surviving. With Gohan gulping a bit of the thought of dying again, he turns back towards Cell saying how if they don't stop Cell here, more people could die, so his life is a risk he is willing to put on the line, but ideally I will be out of the blast radius. 16 is happy that someone else loves Earth just as much as he does, and the android walks out forward saying how he will help Gohan in the fight. Piccolo will have enough power to form an attack that could do enough damage, and anything he will produce will just lead to more destruction and maybe his own death. Gohan, happy to see that he'll be getting hand, does get into a fighting stance and begins to charge towards Cell, with 16 following along behind him. Cell, getting ready to counter whatever Gohan's going to throw towards him, is shocked when the boy suddenly turns left, and in his place comes a fist from 16, which was shot at him. This doesn't do much but stagger the bug, But this gives Gohan enough chance to change his path and come towards Cell and begin to unleash a barrage of attacks into the side of Cell, and this slowly begins to push Cell towards the water. With Cell smacking Gohan away with his tail, he jumps in the direction that he sent Gohan. With him grabbing hold of Gohan by the face, and he quickly begins to thrash the boy around, knocking him into the ground over and over again, and then throws him straight into the ground after jumping up a little bit, doing some more damage. With him then going to absorb the energy of the boy, he feels a connect with his tail and does try to absorb it, but nothing happens. With the dust around beginning to settle a bit, he sees 16 standing there, staring down Cell. With Cell confused at why he didn't absorb the android, 16 smirks and headbutts Cell, staggering him once again. With Cell then smacking 16 away to the side, it reveals a Gohan with his hands to his head, who shouts out Solar Flare, which is then followed by a shout of Wolf Fang Fist, with this beginning to knock Cell back and doing some serious damage. Cell is still trying to get his eyesight back, but Gohan's assault doesn't end, with him tackling Cell until the pair are over the water. He then delivers a massive hammer arm, knocking Cell straight into the water. With Gohan looking back towards 16 to make sure he is okay, with the android being fine but has a bit of damage on his head, Gohan tells the androids thanks for that before feeling Cell's energy rise back up, with a purple beam shooting out of the water and hitting Gohan, sending him straight up into the sky. The boy eventually does roll out of it, however, once rolling out of it, he's followed by a knee straight to the gut, which wins the boy, before Cell turns his whole body and hits Gohan straight towards the ground with a kick. With him making impact with the ground, 16 decides to rush up and fight Cell while Gohan catches his breath. With the boy not taking too much time to wait, he gets back up and looks over to Piccolo, who is currently charging up the biggest light grenade he can produce at the moment. The Namekian is even sweating so heavily from producing such a big blast. He's getting closer to being ready, and he shares a nod with Piccolo. With the Namekian understanding what the boy has in mind, he gets ready to start getting this attack done. Now, up with 16 in Cell, the android is currently being knocked around like a punching bag. With Gohan seeing this, he flies straight back up towards Cell, with 16 being thrown away, with the android looking like it's hardly holding together. Him plummeting towards a nearby island, luckily he manages to catch himself before complete and utter crash, but it's clear he won't be joining the fight again, and Gohan gets back into a fighting stance, ready to go into a fight again with the bio android. With Cell getting pretty annoyed at this, he just wants this fight to be over with, he goes in to fight Gohan. With him noticing that the boy must be getting really tired, as he's a lot weaker now than he was a few minutes ago, Cell beats into the child for ages, making sure that he does a lot of damage. With him finally going for the killing blow, he grabs hold of Gohan by the shirt, means to drive straight into the ground, ready to just smash the boy straight into the dirt. Hopefully, this will kill him. With him managing to do this, and the boy is brutally beaten. Once he lands on the island, he's confused as he hears a shout, well, two shouts, a scream of light grenade from Piccolo and a Kamehameha shout from someone else, with the two attacks merging briefly before making impact, with this hitting Cell hard and making a huge smoke screen. Looking over towards Piccolo, we can see present Gohan stood there. Piccolo is also stood there, and they are both ready to fight, with the Gohan who was just beaten to the ground reforming back with this Gohan. Piccolo praises the boy for using this technique in that way, with Gohan thanking Piccolo. This Gohan knows a wide variety of techniques thanks to the fact he trained with the Z Fighters ages ago. That's why he pulled things out like the Destructo Disc, the Wolf Fang Fist, Solar Flare, Multiform. The boy probably has the Tri Beam, but not to a very good understanding. Now, the boys do feel the effect of what happened to him during that fight, and he falls to the ground. However, he is almost about to drop out of his Super Saiyan form to celebrate, but it's too early. With them not being able to sense Cell, they did think they managed to kill him. However, the bug was not quite destroyed. They were close, they were very close, and if Gohan had not had his power halved thanks to the multi-form technique, he probably would have put enough power into it to win. However, this led to the attack falling short, and Cell has more than enough to regrow himself. With the two sensing Cell coming back, they are shocked and scared when they feel the power of Cell. They hear Cell laughing and then see him, And the android is so happy with his power increase. Just for a reference, Cell was probably at a power level of 500 bill before, and now he's at a power level of 700 bill. With him now being more than strong enough to hold off pretty much most of the Z fighters on his own, he looks towards the likes of Gohan and Piccolo. He laughs and thanks them for the increase in power, and then shoots off a blast towards the two. Piccolo, thinking fast, grabs hold of Gohan using his body as a shield before getting sent flying away from this one short blast. This attack leaves Piccolo to fall unconscious, and Gohan's very weak anyway, and he drops out of Super Saiyan. Thinking fast, he cuts his energy off completely before diving into the water, with this letting Cell lose them. And Gohan, while holding Piccolo, is beginning to try and figure out a way to, leave. And the reason Piccolo took the attack for Gohan is because he was not particularly close with Gohan. He's more close with Goku here, but also because he knew his regeneration should allow him to survive the attack where the boy wouldn't. It was just a moment of using your brain instead of your heart. With this leaving the two unable to fight, they begin to hide, with Gohan swimming off to another island nearby. This leads Cell to search for a few minutes for them before giving up. Thinking they died in the attack, he heads off to look for 17. He searches any nearby islands, with him finding the remains of 16 on one. He just looks past this, seeing how the android is in no state to be fighting. He heads off and just begins to look for his brother. Now, he does think how strong he is now, so thinking about becoming perfect is just so exciting for him. However, he does have a hard time thanks to the fact that 17 has no power to give off. And in his search, he is looking for future Gohan's energy, but he can't find him. This leads to Cell playing a game of find the androids for the next day. With future Gohan and 17 on the move, always, with Gohan not liking this, but they came up with an idea where Android 17 will be carrying Gohan around, and Gohan will be keeping an eye out for the power of Cell, meaning that they always know where Cell is, and Cell doesn't know where they are. After sensing the power of Cell increase, once the two got to hiding on a nearby island, they came to an agreement which none of them like. They understand that they need to get moving to make sure 17 isn't absorbed, and the best way to do that is to work together. They've formed a bit of a better alliance, with 17 now carrying around Gohan to make sure he's never giving off any energy, while Gohan keeps an eye out for Cell's energy, thanks to the fact he can sense, Cell's energy. And the two begin to play very safe and very quietly. And they do this pretty much all day, slowly heading off towards Kami's lookout. Gohan has a plan that if he can just get there, hopefully his father will be ready to come out soon, and he will be enough to take care of Cell. But for now, they are working together. This does lead to them avoiding Cell for hours, and eventually they get to know stuff about each other. It's something that happens over time, but the information that they share is stuff that I'm just going to cover quickly. 17 gets to learn about the reality which Gohan comes from, about how his counterpart killed everyone Gohan loves other than his brother, and he's here to stop that from happening in this timeline. And 17 explains how the whole time he had been free, they haven't actually hurt anyone. The most they've done is stole a truck and some clothes, but other than that, they've just been having a good time. The only person they want to kill is Goku, but after years of getting stuff like that programmed into your head, it's sort of one of the few things you want to do. They have no plans on killing anyone else. They've had multiple chances. With Gohan thinking about this, he does understand that the androids have had a lot of chances, but maybe this version of the androids in this timeline aren't as bad as his ones. With the two sort of bonding over this time, the two only stop running from Cell when night rolls around. The two are close to Kami's lookout and they hide out in a nearby cave. Gohan doesn't explain this to 17, but he's wagering on the fact that Goku will be out of the time chamber tomorrow, and he hopes that his father will have enough power to be able to defeat Cell. And with that done, the two begin to rest, taking shifts to keep an eye out for Cell, with Gohan not sleeping as much as 17 does, thanks to the fact he can sense energy. Now, a few hours go over with Gohan and Piccolo. The young hybrid has managed to get himself and Piccolo to the island where he believes Android 16 crash landed. He didn't fly or anything for this, he just swam, making sure that he could keep Piccolo afloat. He's physically strong enough to do this even without his powers. It's just very tiring for him, and his injuries aren't helping this. He's trying to make sure he doesn't give off any power at all. With him finding a place to hide Piccolo underneath some trees, so if Cell was to look down onto the island, he wouldn't see him. He heads off to look for Android 16. With him not using any powers to find him, it takes him a few hours to find the android. But eventually he does find Android 16, who was pulling himself off the ground and in very bad shape, was still able to move. With Gohan talking to him, the android is happy to see the young child alive, with the two helping each other back towards Piccolo, and Gohan's injuries finally taking full effect. And he has just been powering through the pain most of the day. Luckily, he managed to find Android 16, who had managed to survive the onslaught from Cell. With the three hiding on the island, trying to wait for Cell to leave and for Goku to come out of the time chamber, they just sort of sit around. With Gohan beginning to get hungry, 16 does grab him food, make sure he gets through and gets some energy back. After all, the other two there don't need to eat food, and Gohan and Piccolo get to understand what goes on in Piccolo's head, with them understanding that he is programmed to kill Goku, but once that is done, he's programmed to defend the planet. With Gohan explaining that if 16 wants to defend the planet, that's also what his father is trying to do. It's what I'm trying to do. It's what all of us are trying to do. So maybe you and my father could get along and work together. 16, unsure of what to think about this, they all begin to rest, with 16 staying up to keep an eye out for Cell. When the next day rolls around, Future Gohan has got enough energy back that he can transform. He doesn't test this, he can just feel it. And Future Gohan can sense that Cell has been searching quite heavily for them, and obviously put two and two together that maybe they're heading to the lookout. So he's hanging around the area that they are. Not close, but close enough that it's concerning to Gohan. Now, Gohan wakes up Android 17 and explains that he wants to make a run for the lookout, and if they are fast enough, they should be in a good spot to hold off Cell for a little bit with the Earthlings. And if they work together long enough, they should be able to wait until his father gets out of this thing called the time chamber, with him giving a brief explanation of what it is, with him understanding now how Gohan is so strong. And 17 explains how he's nervous about this plan. If Cell catches them mid-flight, they're in deep trouble. With Gohan explaining how they'll get a bit closer to the lookout and they'll just make a quick dash upwards, and hopefully he'll have some sensor beams on hand up there. 17 thinks about it and does agree to the plan on one condition: they try and save his sister if possible. Gohan at first gets a bit angry about this, not wanting to do this, but he thinks about it and thinks that if it was Goten, he would want to do anything he could to save him. He does agree, and the two begin to slowly move towards Kami's lookout, with the two using the trees near the sacred land of Korin to give themselves some cover before eventually they are directly under the lookout. Gohan looks over to 17, gives him a nod, and then powers up to Super Saiyan. The two begin to fly straight up towards the lookout, with 17 following along behind Gohan. Cell picking this up, he charges back towards the lookout. Alongside this, present Gohan and Piccolo, who are up now, sensing this power up, also begin to charge up as much as possible and rush off towards the powers. Gohan's carrying 16, so he's still going a bit slower and he's not in Super Saiyan. He's carrying 16 because he's hardly holding together. Cell is shocked to sense the lights of Gohan and Piccolo, but ignores this and continues to head off towards Future Gohan. With the Earthlings sensing this as well, they all get nervous at everything that's coming towards them. Tien, getting close to the edge, is looking around for Cell, making sure that he doesn't get up here first. With Future Gohan making it up to the lookout, is followed behind 17, which puts all the Earthlings in defense mode, but Gohan quickly shouts out he's fine, the real problem's coming up now. They need to be ready to fight. And how long until Dad gets out of the time chamber, with Krillin saying he should be out any minute now. Future Gohan knows that they need to hold Cell off for a little bit. With everyone getting ready to, you know, just put anything they have into a fight that's about to come out, Gohan understands that they need any extra power they can get from the small bit of training they would get from these extra few minutes. With him taking a defensive stance to where he can sense Cell, suddenly the bug jumps over the edge, looking straight towards 17 and charging at him, with his tail ready, but as he gets close, Tien steps out in front of the android, who quickly gets knocked to the side, but this leads to 17 moving away from the attack, and Cell then stumbles over a bit. With Future Gohan seeing an opening, he sends off a massive blast towards Cell, with this only really pushing Cell back off the lookout, and Luckily, thinking fast on their feet, Yamcha and Krillin both jump over to where Cell was and begin to send off a barrage of massive amounts of ki, as much as they can throw. With this only really slowing down Cell, Yamcha turns toward Krillin and tells him to give Gohan a sensu beam. With his friend nodding, Krillin quickly stops barraging ki, flings a sensu over to future Gohan, who eats it, and the warrior is now back up to full power, getting ready to fight. This leading to future Gohan getting a small Zenkai after the severe injuries he took yesterday, and also getting his full energy back. He charges up to his max output now and heads down towards where Cell is, with him hoping that he'll be able to do something to slow down Cell. He tackles the android, who is currently in a smoke screen, and charges him straight towards the ground below. It's not doing anything but just get Cell away from 17. Future Warrior did nothing but piss off Cell, who begins to beat into Gohan brutally. With the Warrior unable to do anything thanks to the fact he's an arm down and much weaker than Cell, he has to just sort of try and survive the onslaught. With Tien and Android 17 chasing after the pair who just left the lookout, Yamcha says that the android shouldn't go, he should stay here and hide. But 17 responds that they have a common enemy right now, and if that creature kills him, your best bet is gone. Let me at least help. I want to at least do something. And if this leads to me getting my sister, it's all the better. Now, the first person to make it down is Tien, and he starts forming up a Neo Tri-Beam as fast as he possibly can, with him waiting until Cell gets off Gohan to make sure that he doesn't injure Gohan. But he isn't getting a chance. Eventually, Android 17 lands on the ground and begins to send blast after blast at Cell, which makes the Bugman turn around from the heavily beaten Gohan and head towards the android. However, mid-flight over towards him, Tien begins to let out a barrage of attacks, which, like normal, does hold Cell down, but not as well as Cannon thanks to the effect that Cell is much stronger. But with some assistance from 17, who is sending a never-ending barrage of blasts down into the crater which Tien is holding Cell in, it is leading to the two holding him off quite well. With future Gohan eventually getting back up, he walks towards the ledge. He begins to send his own barrages of blasts down. Eventually, the likes of Krillin and Yamcha come down, and they also begin to pin him down. This managing to hold down Cell for quite a long time. However, with Tien being the driving factor in pinning Cell down, eventually he loses too much energy and falls to the ground. With future Gohan panicking alongside everyone else, they all sense Cell's beginning to fly straight up. Gohan, thinking fast, runs over to Tien and gives him a sensu, with 17 using his shields to slow down Cell, making them on top of the crater that he's trying to fly out of. However, this doesn't do much but slow Cell down. However, this is perfect because with these few extra seconds, it was enough for the likes of Piccolo, present Gohan, and 16 to show up. With present Gohan not having a lot of energy in him, he jumps up to a Deokari form, getting into a fighting stance. With the androids happy to see one another, they share a brief smile before everyone gets back ready to fight. With Cell eventually making out of his hole he would put in, he's very angry. All of these weaklings manage to hold him off, even though he outpowers them massively. Finally, he gets out of the hole, and then he gets ready to absorb 17, getting ready to push for everyone. But soon everyone begins to smile, and it's out of relief and joy and just happiness. They sense that the power of Goku and the others have come out of the time chamber. With the three who had just come out of the time chamber sensing the standoff, they quickly rush down towards where the standoff is, and this is the first time they are meeting Cell and the android, so they're a bit confused. With 16 and Cell happy to see Goku, and everyone worried that even Goku might not have the power to stand up against Cell. However, Goku and Goten are both incredibly strong, and with the combination of all the Super Saiyans, Piccolo, the androids, maybe it would be more than enough. But Goku says how he's impressed how they managed to get in such a bad mess while he was gone. It's only been a day, guys. Which leads to him having a little laugh, but then he gets serious and takes a fighting stance. Everyone else begins to take a fighting stance as well. But when everyone does this, Goku looks at everyone saying how, if they don't mind, he'll be taking this one alone. With everyone really shocked at this, Goku just sort of stands there, with him saying how he wants to test the waters against this thing, if people don't mind. With people thinking he's crazy, but Future Goten looks over to everyone saying, honestly, He has this really easily. Even I can beat Cell. With everyone shocked at this, they all take a step back. With Cell hearing this and confused, he can sense that Goku is nowhere near his strength. He's confused. After all, Goku is at full power right now and he's nowhere near his level. But he does get ready to fight, with him flying up into the air, saying to Goku how he wishes he had achieved his perfection before this fight. But they can have it now. After all, he's stronger than he ever believed he could be. So let's just end this bit now. Please don't bore me, Goku. Goku begins to grin and the two begin to fight. Goku is at a disadvantage after all. He wasn't training to fight Cell, he was training to fight the androids. So he isn't as strong as he could have gotten. But he is holding his own against Cell, which does shock everyone. But this fight is very much going like perfect Cell versus Goku. However, this is semi-perfect Cell this time and there's no arena. However, after a short battle, Goku says how he can't win this battle in this form. With everyone confused at what Goku just said, they look towards Goten and Chi-Chi, who are just watching the fight very relaxed, with Chi-Chi even looking after her present Gohan, tending to all of his wounds, and even giving some aid to the future Gohan. With Goku looking like he's putting a bit of strain on himself, he begins to have a power surge, and people around begin to sense his energy rise. Piccolo notices some small things only he would know. After all, he's trained with Goku a lot recently. He sees the eye colour change for Goku from the green that Super Saiyan makes it to an orange colour, his pupils remaining the colour green, and his hair begins to sharpen just a small bit more. With Goku finished with this transformation, he looks over to Cell with his power now massively eclipsing that of Cell. Goku looks over to Cell saying, "What you're looking at right now is a combination of both Super Saiyan and the Akari form. After I spent years mastering that form, I didn't want to just put it behind me. So my first step to this crazy plan was to master Super Saiyan. And after I did that, I started to try and combine the two, with them managing to merge very easily. And this led to me getting this massive increase from this form. It's taken the multiplier of the Super Saiyan and the Akari form and put them into one. So after that, I started to try and master this form. It's not really something I need to master. It just feels a bit uncomfortable to be in. It's like when you get new shoes. I suppose you wouldn't know that, you don't have shoes. But anyway, this form is going to be more than enough. It has hardly any drain and a massive increase. So let's end this now, shall we? Now, Goku gets serious and takes a fighting stance. Everyone's shocked. Cell is scared. And before we get into this, I do want to make a quick note. I don't know how people will feel about this, but personally, I believe it's fine. I might understand if people say it's very early for such a massive increase. After all, it's a 500 times increase in power, which is equivalent to Super Saiyan 3, if I'm correct. But I believe that if Goku got the Akari form that early, this would be the natural next step for him. After all, it's something that would merged together perfectly, in my opinion. Both forms sort of work the same, so I can't see how it wouldn't go well. I know Saladin made this form like Super Saiyan 4, but for me that doesn't make sense. So I will only be making small visual changes here, things like the eye color. And if anyone else has any ideas for a visual change I could make with this, please let me know, as I just want to make it so people can identify it a lot easier. But anyway, with that small bit done, let's get back to the story. Goku's power far outclasses Cell. And just for an idea, Cell's at 700 bill, like I said. Goku's at a massive 500 trill. And Goku quickly begins to rush at Cell, landing one hit which tears right through the bug. With Cell's body beginning to form back up around where Goku's arm is, Goku learns about Cell's regeneration. And Gohan and Piccolo say that he needs to destroy absolutely everything about Cell. And Goku nods to this, he grabs hold of Cell's tail, throwing the bug up into the air, forming up a Kamehameha, but is soon stopped by a future version of Gohan shouting out that Android 18 is in there and we need to get her out, which shocks everyone, but the warrior looks serious and his father nods. With Goku scratching his head for a minute, thinking of a way how to get the android out, he turns back towards everyone, asking how the hell is he supposed to get her out? With everyone confused at how calm Goku is right now, they don't really know themselves. Cell does try to rush Goku, however, he grabs hold of Cell's tail with ease, rips it off before turning back to Cell. Gohan, the present version, has an idea. He shouts out that they'll just head to Namek and wish her back with the Namekian balls. With Goku looking towards future Gohan, who agrees, Goku then begins to unleash a massive amount of attacks into Cell, with these ripping holes through Cell with ease, eventually leading to Goku kicking Cell into the air and shooting off a beam from his hand, a very basic one, but it completely disintegrates Cell. Nothing is left. Goku then lets out a sigh of relief. He deforms from both states, and everyone is impressed by the power just shown. Goku is praised very heavily, and the tired Goku, who took damage from the first half of this fight with Cell, is happy that it went so well. And future Goten asks his brother why he wanted to save 18, with the future version of Gohan saying how these androids here aren't like the androids from their timeline. They could have killed the Earthlings ages ago when they went into the hyperbolic time chamber. We went to Kami House and it could have happened then, but they didn't. And alongside this, 17 could have killed me multiple times. So I think they have a chance to be good here, so I wanted to give them a chance. Plus, I can understand why 17 wants his sister back. If it was you who got absorbed, I would do anything to try and save you. With future Goten getting a bit tearful, he nods before looking a bit weirdly at 17, giving him a small smile. 17 doesn't know how to respond, but it's soon interfered by present Gohan asking future Goten if he can use the form his father just showed off. With future Goten nodding, which shocks everyone, especially future Gohan. Everyone is surprised by the time travelers being able to do such incredible feats. And future Gohan is happy to see his brother is now a lot more happier as himself, probably because he got to spend time with his mother and father. Now, they can save their timeline with ease. And they want to head home as soon as possible, but future Gohan does want to make sure Android 18 is revived first. So after a few short days of rest, the team of Goku, Gohan, 17, and the Time Travelers make a trip to Namek. The Time Travelers go so Gohan can spend a bit of time with his father, and Goten just wants to spend a bit more time with his dad as well. Chi-Chi was going to go, but she's offered to help Bulma around the likes of Capsule Corp. With Android 16 being there, she just wants a little bit of insurance. And after a few days short trip, thanks to the fact that the ship would have been upgraded over time, make it to Namek. With the Namekians being more than happy to, you know, help the people who saved their planet years ago, they allow them to make the wish. With the group bringing back all those killed by Cell, they have to be a bit specific with the wish for Android 18, saying how to bring back 18 who was inside Cell, but don't bring back Cell in any bloody scenario. With 18 being brought back, she is confused. She is brought back to the place where Cell was killed and is picked up by the likes of Piccolo and 16. 16, who was repaired, she has everything explained to her by 16. With her not really bothering too much, she heads back to Capsule Corp to wait for her brother's return, and also getting her bomb removed from her. She does take an interest in Krillin here, keep in mind, because he is waiting around Capsule Corp. And after getting the wish done, no one's sure what they want to make for the last wish. 17 asks if he could take it, and no one has any issues with it. 17 walks up to the dragon and asks, could you give future Gohan his arm back? With everyone confused, the android looks towards future Gohan, saying how, you saved my life and helped me bring back my sister. The least I could do was give you a hand. We're just getting a laugh out of the time traveler for the first time in ages. He is happy that in this timeline the androids aren't evil. He hopes that maybe in his timeline he can change them as well, but he's not willing to give them too much of a chance. After this is done, the group get ready to leave, but one of the Namekians who knew about Earth and their dragon asks why they didn't make these wishes on their planet. With present Gohan explaining what happened with the Dragon Balls, the Namekians offer up one of the Dragon Clan members to join Earth group so they can have Dragon Balls. With the group accepting this only if the Namekian wants to come, of course the Namekian wants to come to help out at least a little bit more. And for the sake of simplicity, let's say Dende goes to Earth with them. And thanks to this, the androids are reunited. 18, like I said, takes an interest in Krillin. And like normal, after a short time, the time travelers do head back to their timeline. Thanking everyone for their help, they deal with their androids and Cell with ease. Gohan does try to spare the androids, but they are too far gone, and they do get killed. Now, everything here is wrapped up in a nice little bow, and that'll be it for this part. I hope everyone liked it. I felt like this part didn't cover much, but I enjoyed it, to be honest. It was something different. And it's not very often I get to go into a lot of detail during the Cell Arc, it feels like. But I hope everyone has a great day or a good night, and I'll see you next time.